store, they're Italian, they all have the same glasses.
This lady is called Isabella. Isabella told us this cool story about how she accidentally bought $1,000 pair of sunglasses, but hang on time for that now. We've been staying in Seminyak for a few nights. We went to this really cool beach club called Potato Head Beach Club, went out for dinner with Isabella. She took us a drink, showed us around. Seminyak is in the south of the country. Then we traveled all the way up to the northwest of the country. In this crazy village called San Bikino. So basically what I was doing is I did a bit of work for a guy, underwater video work, filmed his reef project, and in return I got to stay in their crazy, and I mean sick, crazy villas. So we stayed there for a few days, messed around for a bit. Every night you get these crazy thunderstorms, and then you get stars as well, and like, it just blew me away. So we stayed up there, really cool. It's like how Bali was 20 years ago, you know, like there's basically no Westerners, no one really speaks any English. It's like so worth going to like such a rural, unrefined part of Bali. So we went all the way up there, and then we traveled back down. I forgot the name. The name is right here. It's really bugging me. The name's right here. I can't remember. But after about 4 or 5 days, we traveled down from the north, back down to central Bali, to this super Ubud. Ubud, that's what it's called. To this other sick place called Ubud. We've just been to so many sick places, basically. We traveled to Ubud.
Wow.
Do not panic.
Do not run.
They won't look them in the eye.
Turn around.
Oh, that one looks pissed.
Can you come shoot me?
I'm walking calmly and slowly.
Oh, that's cute. Did you see it pick it up?
This is like the perfect place to get ambushed by a monkey.
It's opening the bag. Momo, it's opening the bag.
Bites me if I do. That's gone. Hello. I don't like monkeys anymore. Fuck this guy.
Wait till they bite you in the ass.
I haven't got my rabies either.
Happened to both of us, actually.
Oh shit, really?
Yeah.
Should we just walk?
Yep. Off we go. Getting bummed by the monkey. There we go.
Okay, oh,
he's had enough.
He bit me. I went to close the zip and it fucking put its teeth on my finger. Like, watch out, mate. You try and do that again, I'll bite your finger. Some R-rated shit. Don't get too close.
Not sure on that. Hello.
Oh fuck. Oh yeah, I'm a monkey.
Hello, little monkey. Big monkey. Little monkey.
The guy says get nice pictures of the monkey. What you give me a tip and you'll get like a nice picture. So we get a nice picture of a monkey, and the only monkey that jumps on us is the one that's just been through the mud.
Funny story, right? Millie used to ride horses, and I've never ridden a horse in my life, and to be honest, I think they're quite scary. Well, we got the chance to go riding at a place called Ubud Horse Stables, which is like this horse stables where you get to ride through paddy fields and ride horses and all this stuff, and Millie didn't want to go on like the beginner tour, so she told me to tell them that I had ridden a horse before. So the night before, I went on Google and Googled how to ride a horse. So I got there, I told them I knew how to ride a horse.
You can handle, yeah?
Yeah.
But I definitely had no clue how to ride a horse.
Yeah, I've ridden before. Lots.
Didn't like me.
I know.
So agile.
Thank you, I know.
Like a little fairy.
I know.
I'm so glad we're not. This is fucking petrifying.
Gazelle.
It's long enough? You need it longer a little bit?
Just looking after the town. Making sure no crime goes on, you know?
Gallop!
Nope.
Gallop!
No galloping. Oh, really?
Yeah.
Now you're telling me. Brilliant.
What's this one called?
All of us are here.
What we've been doing is, like I mentioned earlier, Sambakima, we've been working with luxury hotels. So I've been working with luxury hotels or villas and offering my videography work, promotional stuff on YouTube. I'll create you guys a promo vid if you can let us stay for like 3 or 4 nights in your crazy, crazy hotel. Like 90% of the time, they don't get back to me, but 10% of the time, I get these like mad hotels wanting me to create content for them. So what we've been doing is we've been staying in like the world's shittest hostels, like for like £5 to £10 a night. £10 a night is like a premium. So like $5 a night hostels, or we've been staying in like the nicest, nicest luxury hotel. So it's like quite a contrast right now. I'm in a shitty hostel.
So after we went to Ubud, which is like in the center of Bali, and went to the monkey forest and did like cool shit like that and almost got attacked and killed by monkeys, we then traveled south down to the coast and we stayed at this place called Comanica at Carrimas Beach. And holy shit, this is like one of the nicest hotels I've ever stayed in my entire life. The staff there are incredible. The actual resort is like mental. It's like right on the beach, and you've got this like glass front villa, infinity pool, the works, restaurant like right on the sea. The place is literally ridiculous. And when we arrived, I had like a bit of an issue. I became really, really, really sick. I think I got food poisoning as soon as I arrived from another place that we were previously at. They wanted me to promote their gym facilities and stuff, and I could barely get out of bed, let alone train. So I had to like drag myself to a gym, attempt to do like a workout session in their little gym. And it just didn't go well. I basically didn't get all the content that I wanted to get there because the place was absolutely crazy. And yeah. So after staying there and me still being quite ill, what we then did was we wanted to go to a place called Gili Tea. So Gili or Jili, I can't remember. But it's basically like a chain of tropical islands off Bali, in between Bali and another island, and really, really small islands. And there's a port that begins with P that you get the boat from to get to the Gili Islands. And what we did was, normally people just go to the port and they just go straight to the islands and like hang around the islands for a few days. But we stayed in the town where the port was for a day so we could do this dive I wanted to do. Basically, there's this ship called the USAT, United States Army Transport Ship Liberty. Basically, and the ship was torpedoed in World War II by a Japanese sub. It's 125 meters long and sits just about an hour north of where we're staying. And there's these guys called OK Divers, which offered to take us out for dives in the area, and they wanted to take us to do a shipwreck. So we went with OK Divers, did the shipwreck, and it was fucking awesome. So, as you guys have probably guessed, well, as you probably know, I've been very, very absent recently. I haven't uploaded in almost coming up a month now. And if you guessed from earlier when I mentioned that I was ill, I've been like super, super, super ill in Bali. So I got something called Bali Belly, which is basically like food poisoning. Normally it clears up in a few days, but I had it for like 3 weeks. So I was like properly ill for about 3 weeks coming up to a month. And during that time, I was still doing stuff. I was still getting out and going diving and stuff, but I just had like no energy. I didn't train. I haven't trained in an entire month. I haven't eaten or tracked food or like eaten over 50 grams of protein in an entire month either. I've probably lost about 10 pounds. So I've lost some like mad size. I wasn't training. I wanted to show you guys that you can stay in shape whilst being on holiday and traveling, and how easy it is and all that shit. And that's my idea for content. And that's what's going to kind of make the whole trip about. But because I got so freaking ill, I couldn't do that. I lost basically all my gains. So I was like, fuck, I can't really make content. I'm like, I'm not very nice to be around. Just because I'm really ill and like just a bit shitty, you know? So I was basically ill for 4 weeks. That's what's been happening. I've been ill. And then from the port in Bali, we went to the Gili Islands. And as I said, it's like these really, really small islands, Gili, whatever the fuck they're called. Went to Gili Tea.
And you can walk around the whole thing, well, cycle around the whole thing in about 2 hours. Only thing to do there is really party or go diving or snorkeling with the like life and shit there, or like mong around on the beach or do shroom shakes. I didn't do any of that other than the diving because I was ill and on antibiotics, so I couldn't actually go out and drink or party. I don't really like drinking that much anyway, but I probably would have done shroom shakes. It would have been funny, but I didn't want to like shit my pants on the beach. So just literally just chilled around there for a few days. Super, super cool. Like I said, it has crazy sunsets, and then did some more diving. So we dived with Lutwala Dive, really, really funny, cool guys in there as well. Like the guys that dived with are fucking hilarious. And that's probably, I did some of my favorite dives there.
Hello.
Oh my God, this is so Instagram.
Yeah, can you hear me?
I've got Instagram for this.
Yeah.
I've got a drone for Instagram.
Okay.
It's a swing.
So I'm gonna call the insurance.
A smoothie, yeah. Vegan juice drink for Instagram.
Here we go, what are we doing? I just wanna see. No. Where are we diving?
Bali.
Where in Bali?
Gili T.
Gili.
Gili T.
Who are we diving with?
Not Tawana Dive.
Are you having fun?
Lots of fun.
How much fun?
So much fun.
Just can't go on the vlog.
Huh?
Just can't go on your YouTube.
And when I'm gone, will you remember this? And even through the warring and the rain as it pours in, when I'm gone, will you remember this? Come fly away somewhere.
Anyway, yeah, so that was my Bali trip. I've got back, I spent the last 3 days traveling back from Bali. So I had to go to Bali, to Malaysia, to London, stay the night in London because it's really late. And then I finally got back to Cornwall, which is in the south of England. So I literally spent 3 days traveling to get back, and I just can't wait to like train and get back onto like actually uploading, creating content and working. Cause like what was killing me out there was not being able to, or not so much not being able to, but not working or not training or not like progressing my future somehow or doing something that benefits me in the long term. Like it was fucking like tearing me up inside. I just wanted to go home so bad by the end of it because I wasn't making YouTube videos. I wasn't training. I couldn't do all the things I wanted to do. So videos coming. What I'm going to do is, my original plan was I was going to get back from Bali, not losing much muscle mass because I was going to train and shit and still be big. Obviously that didn't happen because I've lost loads of size. And I was going to cut until body power and then basically just cut for summer. So Body Power is an expo that's in 2 weeks. If you guys don't know, like, you should definitely be there and come along and chill for a bit. But what the plan is now, because I've lost so much size, is I'm gonna do like a 2 week turbo bulk. I'm gonna try and see how much mass I can put on in 2 weeks. And I have faith that I'm gonna put on, like, basically get back plus more. I'm gonna eat like an absolute beast, train like a motherfucker. I've just overhauled my training split. I'm on another one. If you guys wanna get shredded for summer or wanna get really big, I've got sick training guides here, plug. Ah! So 2 week turbo bulk, I think I'm gonna make a series on that. I'm gonna take some sick before pictures, after pictures, see what happens, and just gonna try and put back all my size on and make like a mini YouTube series. And then after that 2 weeks, we are fucking cutting for summer. Festival season's around the corner, so we get shredded. I'm gonna do a 2 week mini bulk. That series is coming up. If you guys have any suggestions in terms of content you wanna see, what sort of shit you want me to get up to, I am, like, festivals are coming soon, boys, do not worry, they're coming back. I'm gonna make lots of sick content. I'm already in the works. I'm trying to get, I wanna get, like, I spoke to Cornelius and he was keen to come down and come to UK festivals, so fucking hassle that dude about coming to a festival. And Ryan Case would be fun as well to come down. So just trying to get like a solid, strong festival squad together. Anyway, I gotta go. I gotta train chest and triceps and shoulders. More videos coming your way. And actually mean it this time, like, I will upload more videos. I do like a David Lane, I upload a few videos and then disappear for like freaking ages. But yeah, let me know what you want to see. Keep killing it. It's a sick day outside. I'm gonna go and train some chest and triceps, which I haven't done in so damn long, so it's a beautiful day. And leave a comment, leave a like, or leave the comments, leave a dislike if you think it's shit. And peace out. I love you. Bye.